It's Coach Carol coming to you today to talk about the perfect wife syndrome. Is that something that you suffer from? Gosh, can I relate? And I hear it all the time from my coaching clients. You know, like when I first got married, I thought that having a full dinner, you know, meat, potatoes, and vegetable, like my mom always had on the table when my man got home from work, like that was super important. And to have a clean house and to make sure that all his laundry was done and folded and hung and put away, I thought that all of those things were really important to being, yeah, the perfect wife that was gonna make him happy by taking care of him all the time. Kind of like his mom did, right? Like, isn't that what a wife is supposed to do? Yeah. What's on your list? When you think about, you know, when you got married, all the things that you thought you had to do to keep him happy and be the good wife, what's on your list? I'm really curious, all right? Jot it in the little chat down below. And while you're at it, click the little star, the little bell, sorry, not the star, the bell, and subscribe to this channel so that you'll be in touch on future videos. You'll know when I release other videos. Because I'm really standing for women to conquer these kinds of fallacies so that we can be the best wife possible and really to keep our marriages strong and our families whole and intact. Yeah. So, where did you learn? Where did you learn that list of what you were supposed to do as the perfect wife? You know, for me, honestly, it was from my mom, right? Watching my mom, that she always kept laundry done. I would often fold it as a teenager, and my dad's shirts had to be folded a particular way because he was from in the military previously, and, you know, vacuuming, all that sort of thing. And meals was a big focus for her. But it turns out my mom was married 3 times. So maybe that wasn't the best recipe for keeping a man happy. And as I work with my clients and I hear their stories and like what they thought was important as far as being a good wife, I hear over and over that being his maid, actually, it's not what he really wants. It's not really what the secret to being, you know, having a strong marriage. What if it's more important that you're happy when he gets home? Maybe even that you're rested and that you're ready to receive him coming home and wrapping his arms around you. Not so much complaints that he's late and dinner's burnt or cold and where's he been? And like, why isn't he saying thank you for all the work I did here today? Right? Yeah. Being that wife versus being the wife that's just ready to receive the love that he has and being light and being happy. What if that actually is more important? It's interesting that when we got back together, my husband actually started, well, when we were separated is when he discovered the laundromat and that he would take his shirts there and they would press them and they hang them for him. And he's still doing it that way. And it's like, gosh, why didn't I let him do that a whole lot sooner? Why did I ever get involved with his laundry at all? Right? He's a grown man. Why did I become his mother instead of his lover? Turns out he would far prefer to have a lover than a second mother. So I invite you to pause and to think that if your man is not showing up as loving and kind as you would like, and if you're finding yourself being angry and resentful and exhausted because you're doing so many chores and so much work, and when is he ever going to wake up and pitch in? I invite you to pause and to rethink your strategy of what the perfect wife really is and to throw that list out and to try again, to try again. And I invite you to reach out, to join my Happy Wife Facebook community where I share other tips and I share programs. I have a course that I'm offering and coaching is also available to help you uncover blind spots so that you can be on the road to having the intimate, happy, connected marriage that you dreamt of when you stood at the altar. Let's bring that to reality instead of the angry, resentful, frustrated, and where he's pulling away and doesn't want to be around marriage, right? Have you suffered long enough? Come on, join my group, connect. Let's get this underway here so that we can get you on the road to happy. Join that Facebook group. You can learn more And leave a comment down below. Where did you learn about being the perfect wife? And how is that serving you? I read all the comments and I will reply. All right, so take good care. Bye-bye.